Okay, first there was Mudeng, the baby hippo that stole the internet's heart. Now we have our own homegrown hero, an adorably fluffy, chunky penguin named Pesto.
I love Pesto. He's great.
Love you, Pesto.
Pesto is amazing.
I like Pesto a lot.
No, they're not raving about the delicious green sauce you put on pasta. They're talking about the adorable Aussie penguin who's become a viral superstar.
This penguin who has become a huge hit on the internet. And I mean a huge, huge hit.
Pesto is this enormous 9-month-old king penguin drawing hordes of fans to Melbourne Aquarium.
We honestly just wanted to come down and see Pesto.
So we came from Perth.
I'm from California and I'm visiting right now and my dad was like, you have to go see this penguin.
He knows that like everyone's here for him.
And racking up almost 2 billion views online from fans across the globe.
I'm obsessed with him. And nobody in my life gets it.
We love you, Pesto.
Come with us to see Pesto, the giant baby piglet.
The thing no one can stop talking about? Pesto's size. Clocking in at 90 centimetres tall and a whopping 22.5 kilos, more than both his parents combined.
SOS, massive fatty alert.
Can we just appreciate how much of a unit he is?
Not only a big star, he's just big.
I saw him eat so many fish and I was just like shocked at like how much he can eat.
He's gigantic. He's like enormous. It's crazy.
Maintaining that impressive physique with a hearty diet, inhaling twice as many fish as the average adult penguin, sometimes eating more than his own body weight in a day.
He eats 25 fish a day. He's so hungry.
Pesto's gender was revealed earlier this month in a highly anticipated broadcast.
I'm super excited to announce today that he is a boy.
As he gets older, Pesto will shed his brown baby feathers and slim down as he learns to swim. But he'll always be a big boy.
I was amazed. I don't know whether it's freakish, whether it's just abnormal size.
I like it.
I think this is the start. Like, we are witnessing the start of animals taking over. I think this might be the start of that.
We can only hope one of the keepers keeping Pesto very well fed is Michaela Smale, and she joins us with Pesto now. Michaela, do you think Pesto minds us calling him Chunky?
I think he likes it, to be honest. He's taking this fame in his stride. He's a very confident young lad.
Well, he's just walked behind you. I think he's hiding from the camera now. He might need to shuffle over a little bit. Do the penguin shuffle. Other way, other way. Oh, there he is. He's all camera shy all of a sudden. How has Pesto got this big?
So, a combination of good genetics and excellent parenting. So, Tango and Hudson have done a really good job at raising Pesto, taking turns at feeding him, and, yeah, just giving him lots of love and protection.
Now, look, I'm the only one on the desk who's been to visit Pesto in real life because I take this job seriously and I can confirm Pesto is big.
Well done.
I have no other, you know, I'm not an expert, right? So my question, Michaela, you say the parents are doing a good job of feeding Pesto. There is an obesity crisis. Some people could suggest that they are overfeeding Pesto.
Look, you could say that, but I don't think we're too concerned with how he's going. He's definitely on the upper percentile in terms of king chicks. But as soon as he fledges and loses all those baby feathers, he will slim down a lot.
Right, okay. It's good fats anyway. Yeah.
No, I understand.
It's
I understand. It was a question I had to ask. I know it was serious.
Chomping down on cheesels, you know.
No, I understand.
But also, Pesto is a global superstar, and we appreciate all our global superstars in this country.
I know.
Almost 5 billion views for Pesto. He's only 9 months old. When did you realise that he'd become a worldwide sensation?
It's just insane. So probably a couple of weeks ago, around the time of his gender reveal, he started to get a lot of media attention and it's only boomed from there.
You mentioned the gender reveal. I mean, presumably the penguins know what gender they are. So who are we revealing this to? And did you know what the gender was?
Yeah, so I guess we're revealing it to all of our friends and family here at Sea Life. Penguins do and don't know what gender the other penguins are, so we have a lot of same-sex couples within our little penguin community as well. And penguins are actually non-sexually dimorphic, which means just by looking at them, we can't actually tell what their gender is. So we've got to send a little blood sample away and that comes back and tells us what he is.
Michaela, I'm a little concerned, though, because you've said that Pesto could be getting ready for an upcoming bad boy phase. What does that mean?
So when they fledge and lose all their feathers, sometimes their personality can change a little bit. He might get a bit more standoffish, maybe too cool for his friends, the keepers.
Oh, OK, so were we talking about, like, throwing his weight around?
I think he'll just be a little bit more trouble amongst the colony, maybe not so easy to feed, hanging out in the pool, things like that.
Oh.
We're talking leather jackets, yeah. Convertible sports
graffiti.
Cars.
Graffiti.
Michaela, thanks so much for your time, and bye, Pesto.
No worries, thank you.
He walked off perfectly.
Exit stage left.
Yeah. Extraordinary. We love Pesto, don't we?
Yeah. Mm. Did you see glasses off for that interview, Hughesy? Not taking it seriously enough?
Oh, no, I wanted Pesto to feel relaxed.
Understand.
So, yeah, no, big. Good on you, Pesto. I'm gonna get down there. So yeah. What's it like at the actual aquarium?
Oh, I mean, it's like you're looking at a slightly larger penguin than the other penguin.
Wow.
Yeah. It's so hard to imagine.
He's so young.
Yeah.